General Motors readies a huge restructuring. Hello, I'm Tom Warbeck. The Detroit automaker says it will slash its salaried workforce and could close up to 5 plants in North America as part of a massive overhaul of its North American operations. GM today saying Lordstown Assembly in Ohio, Detroit Hamtramck Assembly in Michigan, and Oshawa Assembly in Canada will not be allocated any products next year. All of the vehicles currently being built at the plants are expected to stop being assembled by the end of 2019. Lordstown builds the Chevy Cruze. U.S. sales of the car down 27% through September. Detroit Hamtramck produces the Chevy Volt and Impala, along with the Buick LaCrosse and Cadillac CT6. Impala sales off 13% through 9 months. And Oshawa's Flexline builds the low-volume Caddy XTS and Impala, while the truck line produces Chevy Silverado and GMC Sierra pickups. Meanwhile, propulsion plants in Maryland and Michigan also will not be given any product. Now, not allocating product doesn't mean the plants will shutter. However, it puts their future and the jobs of roughly 6,300 hourly and salaried factory employees at risk. This as GM heads into contract negotiations with the UAW in 2019 and Canadian Union Unifor in 2020. GM also announcing it will close 2 unidentified assembly plants outside of North America by the end of next year and restructure its salaried workforce. The latter move would involve cutting 15% of its 54,000 salaried employees in North America, including slashing global executives by 25%. GM expects the plan to annually contribute roughly $6 billion in cash savings by 2020. GM CEO Mary Barra adding, these actions will increase the long-term profit and cash generation potential of the company and improve resilience through the cycle. In other news, Fiat Chrysler Automobiles is considering options for its robotics arm, Comau, including a potential sale at a value of up to $2.3 billion. That's according to Bloomberg sources. The strategic review of the unit is reportedly at an early stage and no final decisions have been made. Sources say a sale process could start early next year. In October, FCA sold its car parts unit, Magneti Marelli, to Calsonic Kansai. An FCA spokesman declined to comment. Aston Martin CEO Andy Palmer saying Sunday that the automaker is aiming to more than double the number of vehicles it makes by 2025. That's because the company has not yet seen a slowdown in its key markets. The British automaker is on track to produce 6,400 vehicles this year. We'll stay with high-end luxury. Following the redesign of its third-generation Continental GT Coupe last year, Bentley has revamped the open-top variant. The Continental GT convertible is debuting during the Los Angeles Auto Show this week. Bentley says the convertible can hit 60 miles per hour in 3.7 seconds and has a top speed of 207 miles per hour. Oh, and the roof can retract in 19 seconds. Good for that sunny California weather. We'll be seeing lots of new rides in LA this week. Jennifer Vong and I will be on location to bring you full coverage beginning tomorrow afternoon on Auto News Now. We hope you'll join us. Take good care.